What's up, builders? So in my last video, I talked about an automation that I've been using in order to create cleaner knowledge bases from scraping web pages, mostly using Crawl for AI, which is open source. And in order to set that up and run it up kind of like a no-code action, you had to use a Docker container and host a server on DigitalOcean. And for those of you out there that don't want to go through that, there is a more kind of productized solution that I think is worth mentioning here. So today's video, I'm going to talk about Firecrawl, which a couple of people in the community reached out to me and said, hey, Connor, what are your thoughts on Firecrawl? And I was like, I don't know what that is. So let me go figure it out. But anyways, Firecrawl has two things going for it that I like. Number one, it is also open source. So for those of us that want to, host it ourselves, we have the ability to do that. But one unique thing about Firecrawl compared to Crawl for AI, it does have a kind of a dashboard and it's a little bit more productized, and you can run on their own servers kind of with their monthly pricing plans. If we open up the pricing page here, that give you, you know, you can scrape 3,000 credits for this, yada, yada, yada. So this is the actual dashboard inside of a Firecrawl account, and you can see you can just web scrape individual URLs here. So if we go back to the business that we were doing in the last video's example, it was an electrician, right? Like, let's pretend we're building an AI agent, you know, of customer serving. Because there, if we click on this chatbot, this is just going to route to a person on the other end. Like, they're going to get notified. This isn't smart. This doesn't do anything. So give us a minute to assign the best person to help you out. So that's just going to go somewhere. So this isn't like a smart chatbot. We can do something way better. But anyways, so if I go and I go back into this playground and I say, I want to scrape Mr. Electric, what this is going to do is it's going to scrape the results and almost prepare it for ingestion in an LLM, in a RAG knowledge base. You can see I get the markdown response here for the homepage. Well, something that I like also is you can get the map, which if you don't know what the sitemap is or you can't find it, you can just use Firecrawl to also get a list of all of the ones. And if we run this, we see that just putting in the homepage of this website, it says, hey, we found 73 other URLs by crawling it, that then you can then go and crawl all of these in batch. If we look, open the docs, where are my docs at? Here we go. So this is what we're going to use to set up an automation in N8n. So you can see here's the scrape endpoint. Here's the batch scrape. Here's crawl and map. They also have something that's kind of new that I haven't really tested out a ton, which is extract, which it's basically saying you can prompt your way through, like, hey, go find the FAQs on this website. Now, one thing that I'll note is there's only a 300 character count on here, which is really low. When I was messing around with this, it was really hard for me to like delete this. So these are really, really tiny requests, which as you can imagine, it's hard to get specific here. But what's kind of cool is you can use the AI to like generate your schema and parameters. So I definitely am interested in seeing how this kind of grows as it comes out of beta and they kind of refine things a little bit, because there might be an opening for us to target some key information and become a little bit more efficient. But anyways, let's get back to our N8n build for this. So I have set up this N8n workflow, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to first find the sitemap. So we're going to hit the map endpoint here. So I have this API key that I set in the previous node. And then I also have the URL of the homepage, which for this test run, I have set to Mr. Electric, Virginia Beach. So the next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to go ahead and click run here so we can get up to this point so I can start showing you some of the information. I didn't open this because I'm being lazy and I have my API key just dropped right in here. Here we go. All right. So all of those 70 odd URLs here is what we get. So what we're going to do now is we're going to set this into links here so we can then access it in our batch scrape. So this is the batch scrape endpoint that we find in the docs. If I come back, batch scrape, here we go. This is a really, really straightforward endpoint. And in case you didn't know this in URL or about N8n, you can copy this curl. And then when you're in your HTTP node, just import it and it will fill out a lot of this information for you. So you can see I have the bearer API key set for this. We're going to batch scrape. Now, what are we going to do here? So if we go back to the docs, I know I'm jumping around a lot. So this is the JSON that they are expecting here, which is URLs and then an array of all your URLs and then the formats that you want. Now, I actually didn't want the HTML for this example. So I've just have markdown in here. Just give me the markdown because that's what I want for the Google Doc. And I'm stringifying all of these links here. And that's just to format this in the way that the API request will expect it. So what happens when I run this? I get a success true and an ID. And this is pretty common with all of these types. Well, this is basically a job ID. And then I have to do another HTTP request in order to see what the status of this is. So that's what this loop is. It's going to take 5 seconds. It's going to see if the job is done. So this is batch scrape. And then I'm getting this ID as the output from this step right here. So I'm appending this JSON.id on the end of this GET request here. I have the same API key here. And if it is not complete, we're going to reset the ID just because when you go through this if node, sometimes that JSON data in N8n doesn't always pick up the way that it should. So you have to kind of reset the variable a little bit there. But when it's true, then I'm going to come through and I'm going to send this into an LLM. Now, just like I did in the last video, the only difference I'm doing here is I've chosen Gemini. Now, why am I choosing Gemini 2.0 Flash for this? And that is because of the extra large context window that Gemini has compared to the rest of the models, because I'm actually sending a decent chunk of markdown with those 74 pages that are scraped. Now, I'm sure that there is a better way to handle this. For me, just kind of poking around in here and messing around with it, it gets the job done. And then the last node, I'm just sending it to a Google Doc, right? Here's the URL, and I'm getting the JSON.txt is the output of this LLM chain here. So if I continue to go through and I test this workflow, you have this empty Google Doc here. As this goes through, you're gonna see that this is gonna take at least a couple of minutes because it is scraping 73 URLs as part of this batch scrape. One of the advantages of, you know, being on their pro plan or paying for the servers is the batch scrape is, you know, processing all of this in parallel. You're not doing this individually. So I think this should go through a couple of times, at least. Oh, I need to remind myself to show you what the prompt is. I didn't show you the prompt in the chain. But we'll see it once we get all of the data coming through. If I click on this node, we can see the false branches. All right, so it's as each time it comes through, it's going to be false, but it's still in the status scraping. So we're waiting on a status success here. Oh, it's completed, actually. You'll see here. JSON.status is equal to completed. So we're waiting for it to go. And then boom, it finally kicks to true. So the status swapped to completed. So I'm finally done with this. Now it's hitting the LLM chain. And in this true branch, you're gonna see markdown, markdown, markdown. So each of these URLs is being saved in markdown here as the scrape comes through. I'm combining this into one markdown here by mapping it through. Like I said, I know that there's a better way to do this, which I'll probably mess around with. I get an output to the LLM chain finally. This is the prompt. You must have expertise in information structuring, parse this clean markdown. And I've kind of given an example of like a previous response here to give it a little bit of context on things that I like to know. And then here it is. I've got this XML tag with cleaned markdown. The JSON.markdown is the output of me combining all of these fields together. So I come out. All right, workflow completed. So let's double check this doc that was empty previously. You'll see now, here we go. So let me try and see if I can get markdown to actually come in here. I need to, that's okay. Anyways, we'll come back through. You'll see that compared to my previous one where I just did the home page, this has the entire website. Overview, Mr. Electric, family owned, phone number. I've got a URL to their schedule of service, about us. These are the different services. Here are their service areas. Why choose us? Their coupons and specials that they're running. So testimonials. So the last time I did this, I only got 5 testimonials on just the homepage. You'll see that there are way more testimonials kind of sitting in here because they're sprinkled throughout the site. Frequently asked questions come through again, but more FAQs, only like 5 are sitting on the homepage. They probably have a dedicated page to more information on FAQs. Can I replace a light fixture myself? What's the purpose of a circuit breaker? So these are all things that sitting inside of a chat conversational agent is a much better user experience compared to poking around on websites and being routed to different pages and trying to scroll through to find what you want. Contact information, accessibility. So this is a much more thorough scrape of the entire website because we set up map to give us all of the variables that we need and then batch scrape them all and then send them through the LLM and says, hey, I want to craft this knowledge base that's structured in this particular way. So what is the advantage of going this route compared to what we did last time? Well, if you look through the crawl for AI docs, you can set up your own batch scrapes and do something similar. The benefit of Firecrawl, we have these, or the docs, we have these API endpoints that are set up for us. So it's a little bit quicker and we don't have to worry about, we don't have to worry about setting up our own instance if we want to just pay the monthly fee and get, you know, kind of 3,000. Other thing that's kind of cool, you can see my usage. I'm starting to burn through my monthly credits already just testing this out. But the activity logs. So we can see the batch scrape from Mr. Electric comes through and here's the object for each of the scrapes. The other thing that's kind of nice is if you click documents, you can actually download your markdown or JSON that comes through with this. Now, the thing about these activity logs, I only think they're active for 24 hours as far as accessing information. And a lot of these dashboard things are in alpha. So I was having some issues generating new API keys outside of the default. So like I said, if this is something that you might find useful, go ahead and give Firecrawl a shot. The other thing that this does, let's say that I build Mr. Electric an agent for an individual franchise location, and it's great, and it's doing all of these things. Now, somebody owning the franchise, you know, corporate, might be like, wow, this is kind of cool. How did you do this? And the question that might come, you know, to top of mind is, how can I install all of these for my entire franchise? Because Mr. Electric is, you know, it's got a bunch of locations across the country. And how quickly could you build these for my entire fleet, for everyone? Now, using these tools, scraping the websites of every franchise location, a couple hundred, this is something that it becomes a lot more feasible instead of, hey, can you have each of your franchise locations fill out this document that I've given you that has this structure? I can just give it, I can just build it myself. Say, hey, here's a template that I've built out for each of your franchises. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to scrape the information off of all of them. That way, this becomes a little bit more of a scalable solution for your entire organization instead of going through and individually finding out what is the phone number for Richmond's location or Northern Virginia or New Jersey or, you know, pick a location. But anyways, these are tools that I think are important as we continue to build out these agents and have the fine-tuned control of the knowledge bases that we want. Anyways, I know I kind of went through that a little bit quickly, but it's a similar topic, just a different product that is usable. This is Firecrawl. If I have anything more, once I start digging into this a little bit further, anything cool that pops up, I'll make sure to share it. Talk to y'all later. Happy building out there.